We'll start with an opening statement from Coach.
Well, it's obviously a hard-fought basketball game, and I keep saying I really like our team. I think that we're getting better and better each time out, and certainly coming here, playing against the level of competition has proven to our guys that we can compete, and now we've got to learn how to win games. And the two big possessions coming out of the timeout, we drew up the play they were going to run. We weren't on edge enough, and we gave that basket up. And then the last play of the game, we just didn't execute. We were really wanting to drive the ball for two, and if they got in too far, we had two different looks for the three, but we didn't execute that, and that's how fine a line it is. But overall, I'm just thought some really good things. I'm really proud of John Fulkerson today. I thought he really came in and hadn't played very much and learned how to work through fatigue. And but 25 turnovers is too much, especially from guys that shouldn't be turning the ball over. And as bad as we were, we kept on our guys. We just keep playing defense. And the way we were, we could find a way to get it done. And we put ourselves in position. We just didn't finish it.
Questions for Dietrich?
What's been the key for you coming off the bench and being such a spark in the first half, both yesterday and today?
Just coming in, playing my role, and just playing hard as I can. If I play hard as I can, I let everything make up for it. And I feel like last couple of days, I've just been prepared differently, just mentally, on my mental side, and just coming in and just playing my role.
Thanks, Dietrich. We'll dismiss Dietrich back to his team. We'll take questions for Coach.
Rick, is this progress from yesterday in terms of being able to rally and force overtime?
Yeah, I thought our guys defensively, I thought we were really good early. I thought one of the worst spans we played defensively was the first 4 minutes of the second half. We didn't come out of the locker room with the kind of energy that we needed, but we fought back. We've kept our poise even when we've been down and didn't close the first half the way we wanted to. We've got a couple guys that are playing too tentatively where they're not looking to shoot the ball. And when that happens, that leads part of the reason we turned the ball over 25 times. But for a young group of guys, we'll learn from it. And a long way to go in this season. And I said, regardless of how we come out of this tournament, we're going to find out a lot about us, and I think we're finding that out. Now we've got to find a way to win, and we certainly have the pieces and the ability to do that.
Coach, you just kind of mentioned it. You have a relatively young team, and you're giving these ranked teams, you know, a run for their money. What has impressed you so far about your guys?
I think we got a group of guys that they're learning as we go, but they have been eager. They listen, not quite well enough still, but they are trying to be a good team. I think our culture is really, really good. I think that they are starting to understand it's a big difference between high school and college and how you have to play out long possessions on defense. We might have had our best rebounding effort of the year against a team that is known for the rebounding, and it's so much a learning process. But the fact that we are playing against a very high-level group of players in this, it's going to help us because I do think our guys, one thing that we've talked about is making sure they understand they're good enough. I do think they understand they're good enough now. Now they have to understand what goes into winning at this level.
Rick, on Brooks' game winner, is it surprised there when he pulls up, he had time? Are you expecting he probably drives it in? And just what's your thoughts on what you've seen out of Oregon as a whole?
Well, again, I think they got a lot of players in terms of, like most teams this time of year, they're still searching to find where they want to be with the team, their rotations. This is a tough game to play. I thought both teams fought hard, really, really played their hearts out. But Dana's a terrific coach, known him for a long time, and he's obviously done a terrific job with that program. And like I said, it's early for us, and we're with a young team. But every year you start over. You do. You start over. You got to get things going. And I know they've lost a couple games, but I know the first one, think about it. They lost to Baylor and Georgetown, two pretty good teams. And we all open the season with these tough games, but I love what they do offensively, and they try to keep you off balance with their defense. But the fact is, they're a good team, and and us playing against them, I think, is going to make us a better team.
Well,
was I surprised at the end of the game? I'm not surprised by anybody. I'm sure when I look at it on tape, they had really started driving the ball really hard. You know, we knew that, and I think you would expect them to drive the ball more. We probably were caught with their hands down a little bit, but he went up and knocked it down. I don't think you're going to take both of them away from him. And up to that point, they had just both teams had really gone to really drive and putting pressure on the rim. And you look at him early. I thought that he was a little tentative wanting to shoot the ball from there. I felt like he was wanting to get it closer to the rim, but you got to give him credit. Raised up and knocked it down.
Last question for Coach.
Coach, you've been here several times with three different programs. Can you just speak to the Maui experience and how much you'd like to come back in the future?
Well, it's great, and I mean, you look around, everything about this has become a big-time event. I can remember being here, Lord, I can't, 20-some years ago, and this wasn't here, what we're doing now. We'd stand out there in the hallway, and the way they've worked to make this facility what it is today, and the way everything is handled at just a first-rate manner in everything that you do. And the thing that I realized walking in, I mean, I've been here, and I'm not sure I'd say that, you know, I'm coming to do my job, but I could feel the players were excited because they've grown up watching this. And now they can say they've been a part of it. And I love Dave Odom. I think he is a guy that will continue to attract the coaches to come back. And because, as you know now, there's so many of these tournaments going everywhere. But again, we hope we can get a win out of here before we leave. But the fact is, the way this tournament's ran, I'm not sure there's a better preseason tournament with what they do to get the interest. I think they should always try to get cold weather teams to come because I think their fans want to get out of the cold weather and get here. But the fact is, it is what it is. I think they're going to keep playing it up now, what, into 2030, which is only going to continue to get better. But everything, the infrastructure is as good as you see in the NCAA tournament.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thank you.